so we've done it for negative 3. Let's do it for negative 2. 2 times negative 2 minus 1. 2 times negative 2 is?
Negative 4.
Negative
4
minus 1. Negative 5. Negative 4 minus 1
is negative 5.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oh.
Look at this. Do that work. Two, now y is equal to 2 times negative 1 minus 1. Negative 2 minus 1.
Negative 3.
Negative 3. Negative 3.
Oh.
Put your book.
Doing great. Thank you very much.
Okay.
How about 0 of it? 0 is pretty easy to do in your head, isn't it?
Negative 1.
Alright, because 2 times 0 is 0. Right? Minus 1 is negative 1.
Yeah.
2
zero.
Times
cold
1 three. Minus 2. 2 cold times 1 is 2. Minus 2 is 0.
Oh.
Yeah.
There's another one that you can practice on in just a second. 2, right? So we got y equals 2 at 2 times what now?
2.
So we're on 2. Minus 1, that's
4
2 times
minus
2,
one.
Minus
3.
One.
3.
Mm-hmm. 2 times 3, minus 1, 6, minus 1,
5.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just guess.
Swag.
Okay, maybe you got those all correct, maybe not. Mark, do you have a question? How do you get 0? Okay, so that's when x was 1, so let's do that. Y equals 2 times 1. Minus 2. 2 times 1 is 2.
Oh,
2 times 2 is 0.
Wait.
No.
Where'd you get
2?
Minus 1.
No,
minus
1.
Minus
1.
Minus
1.
Not minus
2.
Oh,
it's
a minus
1.
That's
why I got
oh, okay. There.
So it's about to be a 1.
Yeah.
I was right.
Uh-huh.
Very good, Marcus.
I was too.
You way to question the man.
Yeah, Marcus.
Okay, so that was our first exam. Now, in a bit, we're going to start to look at what conclusions can we draw from these results. But just so that we're all on the same page, we're all feeling, where'd it go? Oh,
it's over here.
Negative 3, negative 15, plus 4, negative 11, not negative 19, okay? We don't want to add 4 to 15 and say, oh, 19, and it's negative. Remember, this is a number, it's negative 15. We're coming back to the right 4, so we get back up to negative 11. Let's do the second one, y equals 5 times negative 2 plus 4, negative 10 plus 4, negative 6. Okay, all that, there you go. 5 times negative 1 plus 4, negative 5 plus 4, negative 1. All right?
Yep,
so far, so all right, 5 times 0. That's 5 times 0.
4, 0.
0 plus 4 is 4. 5 times 1. What's 5 times 1?
95.
Listen to my question. 5 times 1.
One
or
5.
Plus 4.
Plus 4.
Nine.
9.
5 times 2 plus 4.
14.
14.
5
times
3.
19.
Be quiet. No, he said 5 times 3. That's 15.
Plus 4.
Plus
4.
I'm going to be quiet.
Never said that.
Chill out.
You were so excited. I had to give up what I wanted. What's that?
Are you working?
I mean, just
practice.
Practice.
Oh. Okay. We're gonna try and establish some patterns. But while we're at it, while we're practicing this, here's what I'd like you to also practice. This function, it's a little bit more involved. Let's take out the negative 3 and the positive 3, make it a little bit shorter. Okay. I want you to complete this table for this function. So let me remind you that if I were to plug in a negative 2 This is what it would look like if I just replace the x with a negative 2. The order of operations. Right, top to bottom, left to right. What do you see before multiplication?
Exponent.
Exponents before multiplication. Do you see an exponent?
Yeah.
Here. Do you see multiplication?
No.
Yeah.
Here, yes. So which comes first?
Exponent.
So we take this number, just this one,
two.
Right? Just this number to the second power first. So this does not become negative 4 squared. This is negative 2, let me write it out the long way, times negative 2 times negative 2. That's what
negative
2 squared means, right?
That's
right.
Negative
2 times negative 2
is 4.
Positive 4. Negative times negative is positive. So here's what we wind up with. Negative 2 squared is 4. So this becomes 2 times 4. 8 minus 2 is 6.
Oh, I did a different one, but I still got
I got 2 times negative 1 squared minus 2. What comes first? What comes first?
Exponent.
So that means we're going to square what number?
Negative 1.
So we're going to do 2 times negative 1 times negative 1 minus 2. And negative 1 times negative 1 is 1. It's positive 1. 2 times 1 is what we have so far. 2 times 1 is 2. Minus 2.
Yes.
I got the
shh.
Hey, 2 times 0 squared minus 2. This is a tough one because if you do this out of order, you might get the same answer and then be confused about how, you know, you did it in a different order but got the same answer.
That is super easy. Easy peasy.
Okay. Fast forward. Write down what I'm writing down.
Okay.
Ready? Here
yes.
We go. We're going to square a number first, right, before we multiply. We do not multiply 2 times 0 right now. Right? We're going to square this number, 0. So 2 times the square of 0, which is 0 times 0.
0.
0 times 0 is 0.
2
times
0
is 0.
Minus 6 is 0.
Now, if you, this is what I'm saying. If you multiply 2 times 0, you got 0, and then 0 is 0 squared, you still get negative 2.
That's only 0.
But that's not. I mean, that is doing it out of order. And if you do it out of order with any other number besides 0, you're going to have a problem. Okay. So just to follow these steps through, we put the 0 in for x, we're going to square 0. The square 0 looks like this, 0 times itself. 0 times 0. Maybe I'll put it in parentheses. 0 times 0 is 0. 2 times 0. 0, and then we find this and subtract 2, minus 2. Two times positive 1 squared, minus 2. That's 2 times 1 squared, 1 times 1. 1 times 1 is 1. 2 times 1 is 2. Minus 2 is 0. Here, we'll just get rid of all this stuff and redo it with a 2. That's 2 squared. That means 2 times 2
4.
Is 4. 8 minus 2 is 6. Notice this little symmetry here. Negative 2 gives me 6, 2 gives me 6. Negative 1 gives me 0, 1 gives me 0. 0 gives me negative 2, and that's kind of the middle. How come no matter what, if I put a negative 2 in there, I get a 6. If I put in a positive 2, I get a 6. What's going on there? The exponent? Has to do with the exponent? What's that? You're done? I have a question. We're answering my question. My question is, why, when I plug in a negative 2, I get a 6. I plug in a 2, I get a 6.
There's negative.
Do you guys?
Brandon's gonna answer, Brandon.
They're both the same, like, value, there's both two.
They're both two, like, they're the same bigness, right? The same distance from zero, but they both come out to be... I mean, look at these other, this previous one here. Negative 3 gives me negative 11, 3 doesn't give me negative 11. So what's going on with this function? How come I get the same thing for a negative 2 as I do for a positive 2? Brandon, you got more to say?
Isn't there the exponent, though, at the... Or the negative 2 at the end?
Right, if I have a negative 2 squared, negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. If I have a positive 2 times positive 2 is also 4. So whether I put a negative there or a positive in and I square it, I get the same thing. Negative 2 squared is 4, 2 squared is 4. Negative 4 squared is 16, positive 4 squared is 16. Right? So no matter what, if I put the positive or negative in there and I square it, I get the same answer.
Wait, so isn't a positive times positive negative?
No, positive times positive is positive. Negative times positive is negative, positive times negative times negative is positive. Alright. Now, we're going to look for some patterns. Let's start by looking at the graph. I was feeling like we're zooming through this thing. It's been some good times. Some not good times.
Are you serious?
All right. So what I want you to do, and I'll give you the first example. I want you to put all of these results, right? We can put these results in a table. We can put these results in a graph. And let me show you one result. This guy right here, where x was negative 3, and at the same time, y was negative 7. So when x is negative 3, y was negative 7, there's a point there. Do that for the whole table, and then we'll see what we see. So I plotted the points from the table.
Okay.
Are these all the points that exist for this graph?
Yes. No.
It goes on and on.
Oh yeah, because the arrows at the end.
Well, not because the arrows at the end, but really, why? I mean, why can we just keep going? How did we find these points? Jaden?
By solving the equation.
Oh, you just plug in an x, do the math, and there's the y. So, can we keep doing that?
Yeah.
For how long?
Whenever.
For eternity.
Yeah.
Right? I can keep going in this direction, right? Plug in 4, 5, 6, and so on and so on. I can go in the negative direction. Negative. Right? I can go in the negative direction. I can even. Could I squeeze in between two of these points?
Yeah.
Right? I could put in an x, what x would this be?
1.5
would be the x value, right? And then I'd have to find the y value. 0.5. So I could find the point in between. I bet you that point would be right there. I bet you the next point, like if I were to go over to 4, I bet you, I'm kind of following this. Do you see this pattern?
Yeah.
I bet if I plugged in a 4, I would get out 7. Let's see, 2 times 4 is 8, minus 1 is 7. I was right. That pattern produced another result. I could follow this pattern again. I could go over to the next one and go up another 2. And so I'll bet you that if I plug in 5, I'll get out 9. 2 times 5 is 10, minus 1 is 9.
Does Kramer used to do stuff like this?
Please don't
work
with
coloring.
So we could keep going forever in the positive direction, in the negative direction, in between the points. We could go in between the points. How many points can I find in between these two points?
Half.
Theoretically, how many points can I find in between here?
Two.
Just one? Just this one?
Oh, wait, no.
I couldn't possibly find this point, or?
2.5.
This point, an infinite number of points in between those two points.
Cool.
Right? Because I can plug it, all I have to do is plug in a number for x and find the y. So I can plug in 1.5, 1.75, 1.9, 1.99. 1.999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999 number of points in between here. But do we have that kind of time? And we don't have enough time to find all of the points, because all of the points would number infinity. There'd be an infinite number of points. So, let's try and see if we can just take a guess and fill in all those points all at once. Just tell me if you think that this guess is believable for in between the points. Do you think all the points, if I were to graph them all, would just start to mush together and make this shape?
Yes.
Yes.
And how about here?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
And all those, I just cut those ones?
Yes.
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 And we keep going?
Yes. 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 Yes.
Okay. What kind of shape is that? That's why these are called linear, right? You see the one line?
Line R.
Line R.
Linear functions.
Line ear.
Linear.
Pronunciations change when you write different, it's weird. It's called linear.
Chill.
Okay. Well. Well, let's do this again for this function. See what kind of shape we get out of it. Well, I'm not going to have enough room to write to graph all these, but I can get most of them. Negative 3, negative 11. Negative 3, negative 11. Negative 2, negative 6. Negative 1, negative 1. 0, 4, 1, 9, and then 2, I just don't have enough, 2, 14. But I bet it would follow the same pattern, wouldn't it?
Yes.
Just be right in this, what's the shape? Right in this line. Okay, right in this line, I'll bet. Keep in mind, remember that when I draw that line, cool? When I draw that line, what I'm really drawing is what?
A line.
The linear.
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 Liner.
Nope.
Infinite.
Infinite what?
Line.
Infinite line.
Infinite points. I'm drawing an infinite number of points. Okay? I'm guessing at this, there's going to be a point there. I'm guessing that there's a point there. I'm guessing there's a point there. I'm guessing there's a point way up there somewhere. That's what this line is. It's my guess at where all of the other points would be. And I put a little arrow to say, I bet it will just keep going and going and going. Now this guy. Let's take a look at its points, its graph. Negative 2, 6. Negative 1, 0. 0, negative 2. Positive 1, 0. 2, 6. Does this look like a line?
No.
It could be a line, just
like
it's
not
a
square.
It looks like a bear that's been
spread
on a rug.
That was very
descriptive.
Demolished. Lines are always straight. Cool.
So if you like did this, it would be a line.
That's not a line.
Okay.
Curved things are not lines.
Zigzags
are not lines. Lines are always perfectly straight. Now with this one, you gotta think about where will the points be? Where will the rest of the points be? If I put in negative 1, I get 0.
Yes.
If I plug in negative 2, I get 6. I bet if I plug in something between negative 1 and negative 2, I'm going to get something between 0 and 6. I bet it'll be like this, right? I bet there's a point here. I bet there's a point right here. I bet there's points leading down here and then climbing back up to this point. Right? And I bet all of the points, if I were to graph them, would start to make this curvy thing.
What?
That's a V.
It's more like a U.
That
one
is a round V. It's more about U.
this was only to show you that not all functions, when you graph them, are lines. Some of them are other shapes, like this one. Some of them are shapes like this one.
Great.
Okay. Some not really weird shapes, but the shapes we're seeing, okay, are line shapes. We're going to talk about next time why they're line shapes. Okay, so here's your homework right there.
Wait,
is that the rescheduled
1.3?
No, Wednesday, 11:10. This is 10:27, way in the past.
Oh!
Whoa, 4.1?
Wednesday?
4.1, that's right, 4.1.
Can
you take a picture of that?
Only